everything okay?
Philip, listen to me. I was married to a wonderful man, and we loved each other a lot, and it wasn't enough. We were both so scared of pushing each other away that we just swallowed our feelings time after time, and I can never be in a relationship like that again.
Yeah, understood.
So I'm going to ask you directly. What are you doing with me? You are a serial womanizer who dates a string of toothpick-sized women. My life is it's messy, it's complicated, and it's hard. And you spent your life avoiding those things, so I'm going to ask you again. What are you doing?
Are you not a toothpick? I mean, I hadn't noticed. Are you serious?
Okay, you know what? You are clearly not capable of having a conversation.
No, it is extremely presumptuous of you to think that I avoid messiness and complication just because I don't go around talking about my feelings like you Americans do, or more specifically, like you do. As you know, I was married once too. She was beautiful in her own imperfect way. She had a little bit of a crooked nose, but it worked for her, and she was blind. We were really happy for a long time. But we had trouble conceiving. You know, we went through 3 rounds of IVF. Yeah. Not only did it consume all of our time and drain our bank account, it sucked all the lightness and the laughter out of our house. She asked to do a 4th round and I refused. And she said that I was just giving up on our life altogether, and I responded by saying, I don't recognize our life anymore, so what's there to give up on? Of course, she packed her bags. She went to her mother's place. And I didn't get to say goodbye before she got in the cab. She didn't even make it 5 minutes down the road before she... drunk driving. A drunk driver hit her and she was killed instantly. So in answer to your question, I am trying. Trying to be happy. You make me happy. So that's what I'm doing. And I mean, is that a satisfactory answer?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Okay. Good.